Hey, this is John McMath, and I want to talk to you about an annular tear. Now, this is something that you may be familiar with, something you may not be familiar with. An annular tear is actually, if you look at your disc, the actual disc itself, there's three rings, and they're very tough. And if those rings tear, what happens is the fluid out of the disc, I think everybody pretty much understands that if you think of your disc as a jelly, like a jelly donut, and when you have a tear, that fluid leaks out. And you're thinking, okay, well, what's the problem with that? Well, unfortunately, that fluid is extremely corrosive, and then that gets on the nerve roots, and then, of course, that causes your sciatica. So the issue with the annular tear is it's very, very hard to, if not impossible, to fix or have surgery. There are some new techniques that are being developed for it, but it's very, very tough, very hard to fix. Generally, the rule of thumb is about 18 months that it takes for it to heal on its own. They generally, like I said, you can't really have surgery for them. You really can't do a lot for them. It takes about 18 months, and generally how it happens, the annular tear is from a twisting or torquing motion. So for example, if you're a shot putter, or if you lift boxes, if you're doing this a lot, lifting boxes, over time and time and time, if you have muscle imbalances, or let's say you have a trauma situation where you drop something or something happens, you can cause that, and of course have a tear or herniation or some other thing. So those are a few of the things about an annular tear, some things you want to ask your physician about if you're having a hard time figuring out where your sciatica is coming from.